Hello and happy Monday, Royal Kings and Queens. I hope that this video reaches you in a happy spirit. And yeah, so today is the first day of Air Boogie Week in honor of my baby girl turning 3. So to kick that off, I will be doing a story time on how I found out I was pregnant with Miss Laretha Lorraine when I was 18. Alright, so this is not like a, you know, a love story, like a happy ending. I mean, it is a happy ending because, you know, I'm a baby and I love her to death. Like, she's my heart and soul. For changed my life. She saved my life. I'd do anything for her. I never hungry with that. Don't mind my pink titty bear nightgown. This is the nightgown I gave birth in. I love it to death. But anyway, so on with the story. So I was 18 and I was with her father. It was a very turbulent relationship, but in the end, I can honestly say that at that time, we honestly did love each other. And to me, that would make Laretha like a pure love child, if you ask me, because it's like just pure love, like nothing but love. Nothing but love is never a good thing, girls. So let me get started on my caution slash how I found out I was pregnant at 18 story. So I was 18, I was with her father, and it was Independence Day. Let's say either Independence Day or Memorial Day. I found out I was pregnant in July, whatever holiday is in July, I think. So yeah, we were out and we had me and my best friend, him and his brother. We had went out, got a room, we hung out there. And after the night was over, in the morning we started back to the house or whatever. So at the time, I am not the woman I am today. Like I said, my baby changed my life. She saved my life, and I thank her every day for it. But at the time, I was not the person I am today. At the time, before I even met her father, I was going through a very traumatic mental, physical, emotional, spiritual breakdown that kind of led and started to the mental health issues that I'm going through today. But due to the fact that I am who I am, I handle it differently. So I met him when I was in a bad time in my life, and he was at his bad spot in his life, and we did some things that we shouldn't have done. And so that being said, we ended up at a Walgreens, and we both got out to get whatever was getting out of the store. And before I knew it, he was looking at me, he was like, babe. I'm like, yeah. He like, police been following us. Long story short, we get arrested, we go to jail, we do the whole booking process. I would tell y'all that story on a totally different story time. But yeah, it was like, this was the first time I have ever got, well, I'm not gonna say the first time I've gotten handcuffs, because definitely back, you know, fighting in school. But not a fighter, I just got bullied a lot, but push on. This is like my first time ever experiencing anything like that. Like, as a child, I was very timid, meek, reading, writing, watching TV. You wouldn't catch me outside unless I was like hanging out with a sister or a friend or something. But like, I was in the city jail with my best friend and my baby's father. So we are in holding cells, and they took me to the infirmary or whatever. I guess I'm supposed to get checked or something, I don't care, remember. But what I do remember is he asked me, do you think you're pregnant? I'm like, I don't know, because to be honest, I really didn't know. Because, of course, at the time I was sexually active with my baby's father, of course. So it was a possibility that I could have been pregnant. So they gave me a cup, I took the test, and of course it said pregnant. I was pregnant with Miss Lovable. And it was nothing like I broke down. I was strong, I was holding my own until they said, yeah, you're pregnant for 6 weeks. I just started crying. I walked out the front door and I went back to my holding cell where my best friend was, and I just broke down crying. And she like, hey, what's wrong? I'm like, I'm pregnant. And she like, I'm like, right? And it was like horrible. So they took us upstairs where the real cells was and whatnot, and I had to see my baby's father as I walked past his holding cell. I just broke down crying even more than I was. And I'm like, that's crazy. I had to find out I was pregnant in jail, in the holding cell next to the father of my child. Like, no, like, that's not what I wanted. But at the same time, I'm gonna do it no different, because in the end, my child will be different than who she is, and she's the best thing in the world. I wouldn't want her no different. But yeah, so I found out I was 18 and pregnant in jail with my baby's father and my best friend. It was a mess. I was a mess. I couldn't. Like, the whole time I was in there, I did a weekend special. Weekend special is when you stay the weekend and you get out on Monday, because they don't release you over the weekend. It's like jails work Monday to Friday or whatever. Once you get arrested in there a week, which is crazy. But yeah. And then a weekend special, I got out on Monday. Me and my best friend, and I was like 18 in my first year of college, not in the best mental health, not living right, not living the way I should be living for a baby, yet that, like, it was nothing but a blessing though. Like, the blessing being the fact that I ended up the way I did, because the way I was living at that time, I could have been dead or in jail for longer than 2 days. Like, it was no joke. And she saved my life. Loretta, you saved my life, and I thank you so much, because if I didn't have you, I don't know where I would. You brought me out of the depression that I was in, and I thank you, and I love you, and you are so perfect, and you are everything, and happy birthday, baby. So yeah, that is the end of my story time. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed it. Young ladies, please do not find yourself in my situation, because it's nothing pretty. Being not only a teenage mother, but being a teenage mother who found out she was about to become a teenage mother in jail alongside her baby's father. No. If you can, please do better. I tell you guys these stories so you can listen and hopefully learn from the things I have been through. And again, like and subscribe if you enjoyed it, or if you just felt what I was saying, because it was like real, like it was a realist moment. I can say I've had a very long time since that, at that point. It's November 21st at 11:53 and 52 seconds, and my baby girl will be 3 years old. And now I just want to say happy birthday, baby. Mommy loves you so much. You are my world. You are my heart. You are so perfect to me, and I would do anything for you. Crazy. Still can't believe I have 3 years. Still can't believe I have 2 kids. But that's life, and it's the real deal. Good night, y'all. Good morning. Good afternoon. Whenever you're watching this, and I hope you enjoyed it. peace, positive love.